Okay, hello everybody. This is going to be an achievement hunt for Welcome to Elk on Xbox One. Let's get into it. Start the clock.
Jeg spurgte ind til Anders, om det var sandt, han var død tre gange. Anders, han var født og opvokset på en vej, der hedder Pine Road ude i skovene. Og derfor gik han ind til Elk hver dag.
The art style's nice. It reminds me of Where's Wally? Welcome to Elk. Roll credits. Why is everything black and white, but the... My mum's a nurse, my pa's a witch. Guess it's a shock for her when he found out. I think I just referenced Seamus Finnegan from the Harry Potter movies. Christ almighty. are you, little bitch? He's a dickhead. Pyro, thank you very much for the resub with it. Well, apparently I can projectile vomit now, so... Yeah, my character is drunk as a skunk. That isn't me doing the wonky warning. The wonky walking. It's the girl. It's the game. Oh, I've gone the wrong place. What's up, bitches? What goes up, what goes down, what goes up, what goes down. New York buttock. I think that's supposed to be said boutique. Why are you kidding me? You actually want me to... It actually wants me to... Sure, why not? The snozzberries can look like snozzberries, sure, whatever. The seal of approval. Oh, Christ almighty me. Some mental health. These people are deluded. I swear to God, if he opens his eyes, I'm gonna say, fuck this shit, I'm out.
Jeg vil fortælle historien om dengang, jeg fandt en mand, som var prøvet at hjælpe. Det er mange år siden. Jeg var ung tømrer og havde taget arbejde op i en lille by langt nord herfra. Og jeg kan tydeligt huske, det var en mandag morgen, hvor min makker Jeppe og jeg, vi mødtes som sædvanligt og tog vores lille ladbil ud til værkstedet, som var den sidste bygning ud mod ødemarken. Og vi gjorde det sædvanlige. Og mandagen, der ryddede vi altid op på værkstederne og kørte affaldet over på dumpen, som jo egentlig bare er en losseplads, hvor man graver et stort hul i jorden og smider alle affaldet ned og dækker det til igen. På vejen hjem er det så småt begyndt at blive lyst. Og da vi kører over broen på smeltevandshælden, så opdager Jeppe, som jo var langsynet, at der var en bil, der var en lille bil, der var kørt ned af børnens kælkebakke, og der lå en mand på jorden ude for isen. Og vi skynder os at køre derhen og løber op ad bakken. Vi tror, at ulykken lige er sket. Og så vender vi manden om, og så får vi et chok, fordi at hans øjne de er sådan krakeleret lidt som knust glas. Han har to sådan røde hugtænder ud af munden, fordi han har slået munden, og det er blødt. Det er så frosset. Fordi det var meget koldt den nat. Det frøs 38 grader. Og samtidig var hans skjorte stod sådan åben og var rigtig dårligt klædt på. Og så vi rev noget af hans maveskin af, da vi vendte
hans
fast i den. Vi var meget chokeret og forskrækket, og Jeppe sagde, at han er færdig, ham der, han er død. Vi skyndte os at ringe efter en læge ambulance, og derefter satte vi os ind i kaffestuen i vores håndværkerbarak, som vi lå lige ved siden af, for lige at sunde os lidt. Ambulancen kom ret hurtigt efter, og lægen undersøgte manden, og de kørte væk med ham. Og lægen kommer så ind til os i kaffestuen og skiller os ud, fordi vi ikke havde prøvet at yde førstehjælp til ham, og vi skulle med det samme undersøge, om han var lændestiv, fordi så kunne det være, at man kunne redde ham. Det anede vi ikke noget om, og vi blev ked af, at vi måske havde svigtet en, som kunne reddes. Senere der ringede lægen dog så efter nogle timer til os og undskyldte. De havde undersøgt ham og undersøgt sagen, og det viser sig, at det var en person, som det var den sidste aften, han skulle være i byen, så han rejste derfra fra min holde. Og han har derfor været sammen med sine venner om aftenen før og drukket temmelig meget alkohol. Alligevel var han kørt hjem i sin lille bil og kører op på sådan et plateau, hvor der er parkeringsplads. Man kommer til at køre for langt frem i sin brander der og rusher ned af børnens kælkebakke, og bilen sætter sig fast. Og så går han ud af bilen og falder. Og på grund af den stærke kulde, dårlig påklædning og hans dårlige kondition og hans meget høje alkoholprocent, så sagde lægen, der ville gå 5-10 minutter, så ville han være bevidstløs, og kort efter ville han dø. Så vi kunne ikke have gjort noget under alle omstændigheder. Det er en historie, jeg engang imellem tænker på, også selvom jeg sidder her i dag en sommerdag, og så tænker på, at dengang der var det altså 40 grader koldere end det, jeg sidder i nu. Så ja.
It's a bit of a weird way to transition, but sure. Oh, this is cool. Okay. This is actually kind of cool. Is that some sort of spring? Poing, poing. That's cool. That stuff's kind of cool. Spider Derp, is that you returning? Oh, okay. It's okay. Don't make fun, I can do that. I can actually do that really well. Yeah. It's a style of singing. I can do it, I can do it very well. It's really easy. If I didn't want to disturb the neighbours, I could do it full volume and show you how good I am at doing it. Like, you ever heard the Halo theme? Like the Halo chanting, I can do that. That's not even me doing it full volume. If I did it full volume, it'd sound even better. Yeah, it's orchestral, but there is parts where it's a cappella. For example, I'm probably going to get copyright struck for this, but hang on, let me just pause the timer for a second. Hang on, let me find it. Let's pause in the timer for a second. Yes, that was the Winamp thing. Alright, let me see if I can find it. Give me a second. Oh, where do I have it saved? I think this is it. Yeah, why didn't I think of that? Hang on, yeah. See, it's this. Yeah, I said I can do that shit. Anyway. I should have just done it this way before. Let the froth overrun. Hey, true. That's a weird one. It's a weird one. Oh, I forgot to restart it. I'm an idiot. we'll just add 2 minutes to the end or something. How's that working out for you? smashing. Golf with your friends, it certainly isn't. I don't think that's how golf is supposed to be played. Actually, I'm pretty sure that this is not... Wait, I was supposed to hit the... I'm not quite sure this is how golf is supposed to work. Sure. God, they're breaking the fourth wall here with a fucking sledgehammer.
They find Yevith, they're frozen, and they look down on him, like, straight the eyes, basically.
Yeah.
Right? And I think that's kind of like a very important moment for the story, a very important experience we want the player to have.
Mm-hmm.
So if Freak will have to carry him,
mm-hmm.
he kind of has to get up close, and we can have maybe get that experience for her as well.
Like,
mm-hmm.
Like we can do it first person as opposed to you.
You're not a ghost, you fucking idiots. I think that guy's a little special. So what am I doing? Snapping a neck or what? Apparently so. Bludgeon her head with a brick. Sounds all you did was surround yourself with lecherous old fox. Not particularly fond of this game, if I'm honest with you. I'm really not. That's horrifying. Game Boy. Clever. It's hard to explain. Not a clue, Spider. It's over the door. a bit stupid. Yeah, you would think you'd be able to, but apparently not. Of course it's gonna fucking do that. Of course it is, Draggy. What's the point of this brick? Well, then it's your fucking job. Deal with it. Coward. Just shoot the fucking cunt. Sounds like a bitch don't want to do a fucking job. You don't want to do a fucking job. Get your gun and use it. Cold shudder. Sue's an alcoholic and she's fucking pathetic. Oh, did not reel it in all the way. Whoops. Let's catch a fish and see what happens. Apparently nothing. And there's a lobster playing with a beer bottle. Oh, for God's sake, this bitch is pathetic. She's an alcoholic and she's fucking pathetic. Hate alcoholics. Absolutely hate them. It's a bird. Makes sense. Nice. Nice. Oh. That was easier. I want to punch that bitch in the face. Enough of the fucking beer. Side note, I can cross stitch. Okay, I'm killing her. I don't care. If she's that fucking desperate for a drink, she can fucking die. Pathetic bitch. don't like alcoholics. They are one of the most worst people in the world. I literally have no patience for them. Hello. I've known people who've hid alcohol, and it's like, get a fucking hold of your life. Hellford Shade, thank you for the host. He's a fucking lunatic. Sue's a drunk. These people need a fucking reality check. Hey, Scorp.
Lad mig fortælle dig, hvordan George han var. George han var, han dyrkede has op i nogle skove på nogle bjergesider. For at forsørge hans kone og hans datter. Og så en dag, så havde politiet spottet ham på en helikopteroverflyvning. Og han blev stillet for en dommer og dømt til flere år i fængsel. Og mens han var i fængsel, der gjorde han nogle tjenester for nogle motorcykelbande for at få beskyttelse inde i fængslet, mens han var der. Men en dag kom, hvor han blev fri, og han tog hjem til hans kone og datter og levede en stille, lidt færdig tilværelse med dem i noget tid efter, han var blevet løsladt. Men så en dag, der kunne naboerne høre, at der var motorcykelstøj på de små veje gennem skoven op ad bjergsiderne. Og motorcykelstøjen, den stoppede inde ved Georges hus. Og der havde motorcykelbanden gået ind i huset, taget George og hans kone og hans datter ud på gårdspladsen. De bundet dem til en pæle, der stod ved deres veranda. Og uden videre taget en shotgun op til hovedet af George og skudt hovedet af ham. Og så var de kørt igen. Imens så hang Georges krop livløs fra hans pæl, mens at moren og fatteren stod bundet, efterladt på gårdspladsen. Jeg mødte enken og datteren på en bar en sen aftentime, hvor datteren, der nu var en voksen kvinde, var med hendes mor i byen. Og sidst fik jeg taget mig mod til at spørge dem, om den historie, jeg havde hørt, den var sand. Og moren, hun genfortalte historien nogenlunde, som jeg havde hørt den. Og da hun var færdig, så sad datteren og stirrede lidt tomt ud i luften foran sig, hvorefter hun sagde, at the day daddy die, I never forget.
Excuse me.
Thank you.
So you're a fucking lunatic. Stupid bitch. All of these people are off their fucking trolleys. They are fucking stupid. She's a coward, she's an alcoholic, he's a lunatic. Oh, for fuck's sake, Sue. Just shoot him. Sue is a fucking drunk moron and needs to be punched in the face. I literally have absolutely zero fucks for alcoholics. Behold my field of fucks, and to see that it is barren. This is what happens when you don't give people the mental health they need. You're a fucking retard going to kill themselves. That's sad, because he's clearly special in the head and he thinks he's a fucking ghost. He should be locked up. Christ almighty. If this isn't going to be a psychiatric hospital, I'm going to be sincerely disappointed. Please be a psychiatric hospital. It should be. Nope. It's the one that I made. Almost. Breaking the fourth wall much. Breaking the fourth wall much. What's with the flamingo? Well, this has been Welcome to Elk in 2 hours 21:14. How can you make so many characters with so many flaws for people that you just want to punch in the face? Seriously. It's an okay game, but so many characters, it's like, yeah, you're just gonna let them be like that and not help them. Anyway, thank you everybody for watching. This has been the Achieve Hunt for Welcome to Elk on Xbox One. See you next time.